Hey guys, welcome to my channel, The Mechanical Engineer. So today we are gonna see a numerical based on mechanical vibration. Establish the differential equation of motion and find expressions for the critical damping coefficient and the frequency of vibration for the system shown. So here we have a system over here. So this is a rod whose one end is connected to pivot O, and there is mass on other end. We have a spring and a damper connected to the rod at distance A, and the length of the rod is L. So here we have the mass, or this mass M, which is 2 kg. K, that is the coefficient of stiffness for the spring, is 4000 newton per meter, and length of this rod is 200 mm, and the distance A from the pivot to the point where the spring and the damper are connected is 75 mm. And we have to also find the value of the damping coefficient for which the system is critically damped. Okay, so we have to find the differential equation of motion and the expression for critical damping coefficient and frequency of vibration. And we have to also find the value of damping coefficient for which the system is critically damped. So here we have to find 4 different things. So this is one of the very important question which can come for 5 to 10 marks. So here first we are going to see the diagrams for this. Okay. So here we have the mass M. This is the initial position of the rod, and after deflection by an angle theta, this is now the final position of mass M. So this is the distance A, this is the distance, the X is the distance of the elongation of the spring K, which is equal to A into theta. Okay, so this is a free body diagram. So here we have the inertia torque acting on the rod, and here there is a spring force acting on this side. Since the spring gets elongated over here, so it have to come to its original position. So it applies a force over here, which is spring force denoted by F. That is F is equal to kx. Now we have a damping force over here on the same point. Since the damper here is compressed due to the displaced position of the rod, so now we have the damping force acting upwards, and it is denoted by Fc, which is equal to C into x dot. So the torque is force into the length at which the force is acting. So the spring torque, which would be kx into A, and the damping torque, which is Fc, that is damping force into A. So here we have the formula, that is inertia torque plus external torque, summation of inertia torque plus external torques is equal to 0. So here inertia torque we have is I theta double dot. And for external torque, we have 2 torques over here. That is, one is the torque due to spring, and the other one is due to the damper. So we have is I theta double dot C into X dot into A. That is due to the damper over here. That is C into X dot into the length A at which the force is acting, and due to the spring force, that is Kx, and A at a distance which it is acting. So now, as we knew, the distance x is equal to A into theta. So after differentiating it, once we get x dot is equal to A theta dot. So we will substitute the value of x dot and x in this equation. So now we have I naught theta double dot plus C A square theta dot. Here A square, one A is over here, and we multiply it with another A from here. We have A square theta dot, And same way we have k a square theta is equal to 0. So now we have theta double dot plus c a square by I 0 into theta dot plus k a square by I 0 into theta is equal to 0. In this equation, we take this two equation, that is c a square theta dot plus k a square theta on this side. So we have I naught theta double dot is equal to c minus of c a square theta dot minus k a square theta. After that, we divide the whole equation by I naught. So here, when we divide it by I naught gets cancelled, and on the other side we have c a square upon I naught into theta dot minus k a square upon I naught into theta. So we bring this equation again to this side of the equal to, and we get this equation over here. So this equation over here is the fundamental differential equation of the motion, and it is of second order, since you can see the order here is 2. So it can be written as theta is equal to e raised to st, and we differentiate with respect to time. So we have s e raised to st, and we differentiate it again. So we have theta double dot is equal to s square e raised to st. We substitute this value of theta, theta dot and theta double dot in this equation over here. So now we get s square e raised to st plus c a square I naught e s into e raised to st and k a square upon I naught e raised to st. Now we divide this equation with e raised to st. So e raised to st gets cancelled. So now we have s square plus c a square upon I naught into s plus k a square upon I naught equal to 0. So now we are gonna take the coefficient of all these three terms. This is a quadratic equation, so it's the coefficient of s square is 1, the coefficient of s is c a square upon I naught, and the coefficient over here is k a square by I naught. So we will name this coefficient as a, this one as b, and this one as c. So we are gonna put a formula, that is b plus minus root of b square minus 4a whole upon 2a. So we are going to substitute the value of this a, b and c in that equation, and then this is what we are going to get, that is c a square upon I naught, that is b, plus minus root of c a square upon I naught the whole square, which is b square, minus 4 into k a square by I naught, which is 4ac upon 2a. So now after solving this equation, we get c a square upon 2 I naught plus minus root of c a square upon 2 I naught the whole square minus k a square upon I naught. So now we have to find the formula, the equation for the critical damping coefficient. So what we have to do is simply take this c a square upon 2 I naught the whole square equal to k a square upon I naught. So this is what we have here. Then we are gonna put cc, that is the critical damping coefficient, over here in the place of c. So then we have c c a square upon 2 I naught the whole square is equal to k a square upon I naught. So here we are going to remove the bracket and multiply the square all over this place. So we have c c square a raised to 4 upon 4 into I naught square is equal to k a square upon I naught. Therefore c subscript c square is equal to 4 a square upon I naught into 4 I square by a raised to 4. We take all both of these terms, that is a raised to 4 and 4 I naught square over here on this side of this equal to, that is the right side. So now we have c c square is equal to 4 k into I upon a square. So what we have, this I naught and this square from here gets cancelled, so we have 4i, and this a square get cancelled, and what remains over here in the denominator is a square, so we have k 4i upon a square. So now to remove the square sign, we have to put a root sign on the right side of the equal to, so we have root of 4ki upon a square. So then we solve it and we get 2 root of ki upon a, and we know the value of I is m into l square, the mass into the length square. So we substitute the value of I as m l square upon a over here, then we take this l out, so now we have cc is equal to 2l by a into root of km. So this is our answer. We have found the critical damping coefficient, the equation for critical damping coefficient. So now this is our cc. Now we have to find epsilon in order to find the frequency of damped vibration. So here we have the formula for epsilon, which is c upon c subscript c. So we put the value of c subscript c in this equation, we get c upon 2l by a root of k into m. This k, which is in the denominator of the denominator, goes to the numerator. So here we have ca upon 2l root of km. So now our another step is to find the equation for the frequency of damped vibration. So here we have the formula. We have WD, since it is the damped vibration, is equal to omega n root of 1 minus epsilon square. So here we are going to multiply the omega n inside the root. We have root of omega n square minus omega n square epsilon square. So we substitute the value of omega n, which we got from the fundamental differential equation, as k a square upon m l square minus this omega n again, which is k a square upon m l square multiplied by the value of epsilon, which we got over here, c a upon 2 l root of k m the whole square, since there is a square sign over here. So after solving this equation, what we have here is we removed this bracket, took the square sign inside the bracket, so we have c square a square upon 4 l square k into m. So then we cancel this k from here and this k from here, we multiply the a over here, so we have c square a raised to 4 upon, we multiply this both m, we have m square into l raised to 4 into this 4, and or we take this a raised to 4 and l raised to 4 outside the bracket, we have k by m minus c square a square upon 4 m square l square. So this is the frequency of the omega d. So now we substitute this omega d in the formula of frequency of damped vibration, which is fd is equal to omega d by 2 pi. So we are going to substitute this value in this equation over here. So we have fd is equal to 1 upon 2 pi into a by l root of k by m minus c square into a square whole upon 4 m square l square, and it is the frequency is denoted by hertz. So now this is again the second answer what we got, the third answer actually what we got. The first was the fundamental differential equation, the second was the critical damping coefficient, and this is the third one, the frequency of damped vibration. So the last one we have is the damping coefficient. So this is the formula which we got for the damping coefficient, the critical damping coefficient. And in the question we saw the given information, that was the mass is 2 kg, the stiffness is 4000. Over here there is a mistake over here, there should be 4000 newton per meter, and length is equal to 200 mm. and A is 75 millimeter. So the critical damping coefficient is 2L by A root of K into M. It is 2 into 0.2 upon 0.075 root of 4000 into 2. We substitute all these value in this equation. We get C subscript C is equal to 477.02 Newton second per meter. Thank you for watching my video, guys. Hit the like button and subscribe my channel if you like my videos. Thank you.